Monday at, it's 8:30 a.m. and we're right outside of Denver, Colorado, and we are on the road to Hazel Crest, Illinois. And we got word from our eyes on the sky, Bob Marine, that we might be hitting some severe thunderstorms when we are going through Iowa today. So that's pretty exciting. Traffic is pretty heavy right now, but we're on the road. So we have our 14-hour drive today. We're losing an hour, so we should be getting in around 11 p.m. Central Time. Not too excited about that and all the cornfields that we may see. So anyway, it'll be an interesting day. Our driving technique for our 14-hour day is Miss Danny Netland is starting us out today. And then Elise will probably start driving. We're gonna do 2-hour increments and then change. That way we don't get too bored or tired too fast. So anyway, that's our driving techniques for the day, just so you know.
It's a beautiful day, but I'm stuck inside, staring at this screen, working 9 to 5. How I hate this job, cause the days do drag.
So we're driving on I-76, we're still in Colorado right now, and I was very shocked how quickly it flattened out after we got out of Denver. It's pretty much immediate. I expected there to be a little bit more mountains. It pretty much flattened straight out into fields and not a lot more. Yeah. So this is going to be the rest of our day. Fields. More fields.
Soon our fields will change into
cornfields.
Cornfields, yeah.
They work me like a dog.
Nebraska, and we just realized two things. One, that we went into Central Time, so it's now 2:00 in the afternoon, and also we realized that we forgot my allergy medication in the fridge back in Denver. So that was an easy fix. We called and they're gonna ship it home. So that's what's going on. It's still fields, lots of fields. Not much has changed at all. It's still flat. We're going down in elevation. So we're supposed to be getting in, the GPS says, at 1 a.m. tonight, but I am betting 11:00. So we'll see. We have 721 miles to go.
Looking at my watch for the millionth time. The days go slow and then the evenings fly. When I'm out of this place and the day's been won, I'm going out with my mates, hanging out in the sun. Oh, cheer up, don't be blue.
That bridge that you just saw was the only change in scenery in the past, 500 miles, I think?
Yeah.
So that was pretty exciting for us for a moment there. We don't know what it was.
Yeah, it's home time soon. We'll make it through another working day. I need a holiday. I need a holiday with my friends. be Sunday when I wake up every day. I wish it could be Sunday when I wake up every day. I wish it could be Sunday when I wake up every day. I wish it could be Sunday when I wake up every day. I wish it could be Sunday when I wake up every day. I wish it could be Sunday when I wake up every day. I wish it could be Sunday when I wake up every day. I wish it could be Sunday when I wake up every day. But I need you. Yeah, I need you. Yeah, I need you more than I can say. Yeah, I need you. Yeah, I need you. Yeah, I need you more than I can say. More than I can say. Yeah, I need you. I need you. I need you. I need you. I need you more than a holiday.
Yeah, I need you. We are somewhere in Iowa near the Illinois border. And we found the world's largest truck stop, and it was pretty awesome because we were on the highway, and I was like, oh, I never got to have Dairy Queen in California when we went the other night, and we saw a sign. So we pulled over, we got Dairy Queen.
At 10:20 at night.
So we still have about 185 miles to go or so.
And at Dairy Queen, we also discovered something.
They don't have chocolate sprinkles anymore.
Which is lame. I asked, I said, all right, can I have a chocolate and a cone with chocolate sprinkles? They bring me rainbow sprinkles.
Yeah. And it's stupid because that happened in California too. Neither times did they tell them they don't have chocolate sprinkles.
But they still charge you for the sprinkles.
And they put weak amount of, they like shook it on top, then roll it in so it was like every inch was covered.
And I feel lame making a big deal about chocolate versus rainbow, but it is a big deal.
They do taste different.
And so if you go to Dairy Queen, they don't have chocolate sprinkles, I guess.
Well.
So we're gonna hit the road again. Still have about what, like 3 more hours?
A little less than 3 hours.
Danny's been driving for like the past 3 hours, so it's been good.
I'm gonna keep driving because driving keeps me entertained.
So yeah, we're rocking on. Danny the driver, she's getting us there.
I need you, I need you, I need you.
So it's 3 a.m. and we checked into our hotel at Super 8 and right outside of Chicago, Illinois, and it was a very long day, 18 hours of driving. So it was very long cornfield, that's why you won't see much video. It's probably going to be a short video just because there was not much to see at all. Danny, how do you feel about the hotel we're in?
Oh, the hotel room is dirty.
I hate it.
Yeah, we're kind of sketched out. There were like people at 3 o'clock in the morning sitting in a car right outside the door. That was a little weird.
Yeah.
It took us forever to get here. We had to go like these back roads because there's a huge accident on whatever I-80.
Yeah, we didn't think it was gonna get much worse until we actually got into our hotel room, and it does.
It does get worse. We got a nice little tour of whatever state we're in, Illinois. All these like all they have is power plants, I think.
Yeah.
I'm sure we went by like 20 of them. Power plants and gas stations.
And they didn't clean the toilet because we found some droppings. So yeah.
And the carpet feels just really unclean.
And same with the bathroom floors. I went in, my feet stuck to the floor.
And same with the beds. It
so,
just
yeah.
feels really unclean.
3 hours of sleep in nasty
yeah.
beds.
Yeah.
Sweet.
So, bye.
Yeah.
Time for bed.
Bye.
Bye. All right, so it is 3:51 a.m. Central Time, and right outside of Chicago, our Super 8 experience was not a good one.